Broadcasting across America and around the world.
Such a name, he talking now.
Live from our studios in Sumter, South Carolina.
What's this?
You're listening to PowerAndPraiseRadio.com.
Let me go. Be real.
Shining bright. Going hard. Living big. Like a star. They trying to get it. Already got it. And there ain't nothing no one can do about it. We living that blessed life. We living that blessed life. We living that blessed life. We living. We living.
Everybody talking about trying to hustle hard. But don't nobody want to talk about God. Trying to get it in. We trying to win. But don't nobody seem to know where to begin. Hey. Well, I'ma tell you something. I hope you listening. Life gets better when Jesus is your friend. You can tell him anything. He'll tell you everything. No competition. How you win it every day.
Shining bright. Going hard. Living big. Like a star. Ain't trying to get it. Already got it. And ain't nothing no one can do about it. Cause we living that blessed life. We living that blessed life.
You on a mission, now I can understand. You got ambition, you've been dreaming big since you was a kid. Waiting for the dream to come alive so you can live.
Well, I'ma tell you something, I hope you listening. Life gets better when Jesus is your friend. When you give him everything, he'll give you everything. No competition, how you win it every day.
Shut it right,
going hard, living big, like a star.
Your declaration on today. Welcome, welcome to our show of Destiny Talk, an hour of inspiration, motivation, and activation towards your destiny. It's your host, Lady Cook, and in the studio with me today, we have Destiny Walkers. We have Lady Sylvia.
Good evening, good evening.
We also have Lady Carolyn Johnson with us in the studio.
Greetings.
So I'm excited about the ladies that's joining me on the Destiny Talk show on tonight. And boy, do we have a show prepared for you. We're going to finish our conversation that we started when I was last on the air, the conversation on faith and the family. During this month, we are focusing on forward faith, putting our beliefs into action, mm-hmm. making those words and making those actions work for us. Yes. Because, you know, that is what faith does.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You know, you have to work your faith in order for faith to manifest itself and for things, you know, to speak and declare and decree things to come mm-hmm. into your life. You have to work faith.
That's exactly mm-hmm. right.
And that's what we're talking about. faith and how it works, and our faith and how it's, you know, benefiting us as families, and not just your, you know, not just your blood family, or you know, but we're talking about like your church family,
the body.
We're talking about the body of Christ. We're talking about how activating our faith, it benefits us as a body. That was very good. And we know that the Bible tells us that without faith, you know, it's impossible to please God. So we can, you know, like, again, we can speak and we can declare all these things, you know, through our words and through our action. But if we're not moving, faith has to, it's an action.
Exactly,
it's
right.
An action.
Action,
action words. So we have to move our faith. We have to move our faith. And so I'm excited that we're going to get into some dialogue on tonight about, you know, forward faith, faith in the family. How can we elevate our faith? The things that we need to do to purpose in our thought life, to purpose when the words and the things that we speak, those things elevate us and sets us up for victory.
Yes.
And I don't know about you, but I love living, like the song said, a blessed life.
Yes.
I like living a victorious life. I like knowing that, you know, when I lay down at night and at the end of the day, when I'm having my conversation with God, or when I'm saying my prayers, or when I'm, you know, reflecting, then I feel good knowing that I have lived a purposeful life for that day, and I lived it in faith.
Yes.
And I lived it according to the beliefs and what I have, and the God that I, you know, the God that I believe in. And I could just rest assured to know that he'll continue to bring those things to pass, you know, for me and bring them in my life. And so that's what we want to encourage you with on tonight. So you know how we, you know how we do. We tell you to grab your writing utensils and grab your notepad. And right after our first song break, we'll be back and we're going to go right on into our scriptural focus, and we're talking about forward faith.
I will.
Our scripture of focus for the show is coming from Psalm 46 and 10. And actually, we have a few of them because I'm sure the ladies have a scripture or they have something that they want to share. Again, because we're talking about elevating and uplifting our faith. And there's so many scriptures in the Bible that pertains to faith. You know, and our elevation of it. But the first one that I wanted to bring out tonight is coming from the book of Psalm, the 46th Psalm, the 10th verse. And it says, be still. Be still and know that I am God. You know what that's saying to me right there? In the midst of everything. Sometimes you got to calm yourself in the middle of the storm. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. We as Christians, we as Americans, however you want to group ourselves into all of, you know, of what's going on, the catastrophic atmosphere, if you will, that's going on out there in the political environments and things that's taking place now. We are missing too many blessings because we are not exalting God in our circumstances.
That's right.
And from a broader perspective, we're not exalting him in the world.
That's right.
We have as Christians, it's time for us to speak up and to speak out about our God. And we have to do that in order, do that in an order, in a spiritual order. Correct. And sometimes when things get chaotic around us, just as the scripture says, you got to be still and let God be God.
Yes.
The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof.
I think that's the biggest problem, though, is the being still. As the people, we want to hurry up and wait. You know, being still and knowing is the power part of that scripture. Be still and know. You know, a lot of people say, if you don't know who you are, you don't know whose you are. You know, so you got to be still and know that God has got this. He's got this. He's not a man that he shall lie. His word will never return void. So just be still. Find comfort in knowing. But in order to do that, you've got to create the faith.
And there we go. Since he already done put it on out there, let's just roll right on into it. I think, again, we're lacking a lot of blessings, and we're lacking, you know, we're lacking those things that we want to have in our life to be considered to be living, you know, that blessed life. We're lacking them due to inactive faith. Inactive faith.
Right.
And so let's talk about that for a moment, because as I said, I know y'all have some scriptures and things that you know that God has placed on your heart. And this is our scriptural focus segment. And so we want to be able to give our Destiny listeners, we want to give those some good meat out there so that they can, you know, write these scriptures down and go back and let them speak to their hearts. Because above all, we want you to really get this. And, you know, as they say, the scriptures and the word is food for your soul. It's good for you to get this and to meditate on this and get it in your mind, because a lot of times we have to change the way that we think, our perception, the way that we see things. And what helps us do that all the more, and what helps calls us into the abundancy and calls us into the prosperous life, and to be living, you know, to be living, you know, above, you know, above average. I don't know about y'all, but I want to live above
average.
I want to live in that faith realm. I want to wait, like I say, when I lay down, everything's all good. And then when I arise, when I get up the next morning, I'm like, God, you done it again. And I'm ready to put my faith forward. I'm ready to, you know, put my steps, you know, order my steps, Lord. Order my steps. What scripture do you have for us, Lady Carolyn?
I have Luke, the first chapter, the 37th verse, for it says, for nothing is impossible with God. This scripture says to us that there's absolutely nothing impossible with God. The thing is, you have to activate your faith. There's an action there. You cannot just walk around saying, oh, I know God will make a way. I know that. But where is your faith? Do you know what way he is making? A lot of us have faith. It's not the size of the mustard seed, though. Mustard seed, when you think about that mustard seed, it's the smallest. There's not a there's not an object on this table that can measure up to the size of a mustard seed, because it's so small. just that little bit of faith of knowing that God will do just what he said. If there's nothing that's impossible, then what is it that God cannot do?
That's a good question.
Why is it so hard to believe that that thing cannot be done? Where then have we set our faith? We believe that the bank got all the money, so I'm going to go and ask them for it. Have you consulted God?
Right, and then sometimes we got to look sideways and we'll be like, well, you know what? Like we were saying, oh, I want that house and I want that car. But it's wisdom of the spirit of discernment. Has it rest on your heart to say, well, it's your season or it's time for you to receive that house or that car?
So what happened to God, if it's your will?
Let it be done.
Let it be done. Because we get confused with that scripture that says God promises our heart's desires, but our heart is not lined up with his heart. He also wants us to be like him.
Right. Oh, that's good. That's good conversation.
But even
right
when
there.
We talk about his will, and you know, we say that as believers quite often. God is your will. Let your will be done. But are we trusting what we're saying?
Right.
Because when you really say, God is your will, let your will be done. Even when we're praying for a loved one, God is your will. I mean, they're sick, is your will. But are you trusting and believing God's will? Because what if it doesn't go the way that we're human, that we're really thinking it should go? But you said out of your mouth, God's will. So now you got to trust him.
So, Lady Sylvia, do we even understand God's will? Exactly. Have we studied to show ourselves knowledgeable enough to know what is the will of God?
The will of God,
You know, I said earlier, you know, I saw a lady, 98 years old, and she'd gone on home to be with the Lord. As a matter of fact, she was ready to go.
She's ready to go.
She'd lived a good life, and a good, a blessed life. You know, and she went home peacefully. There's some things that she'd asked God for. She wanted to see her children grown, her grandchildren grown. She wanted to be in a right mind. God gave her all of that.
All of that.
But here we are, the people that are left behind, you're so distraught. What about honoring God for that which he has done? It was in his will that she lived 98 years.
The blessed 98 years.
And I'm standing to the side, Lord, I pray that you bless me, Jesus.
So that I can make
so that I can see 98 years in my right mind, still moving around, being effective, serving you.
And that, let me tell you.
Wow.
We were talking about, the, you know, the will of God, knowing the will of God, but the will of God is the way of God.
It's the way of God.
The will of God is the way of God.
That's right.
So we can speak and we can say all of these things, but also lack so much. We lack the substance when we don't know the ways of God. And how do you know the ways of God? By getting into the Word of God.
That's right.
You've got to let the Word of God get down into your heart, get into your mind, and once you start feeding yourself, it's like you know, it regenerates itself. The Word works, so it will start working in our lives, so the manifestations become real. And so someone texted me and said, you know, we got the Burger King generation going on. We want it our way,
right? And we believe what we see.
We want it our way, but it's not so. If you want the will of God, then you got to be in the way.
That's right.
Of God, you got to understand it. You got to know the working.
That's
right. The master, the one who created the universe, the one who created you, the one who can give you all things that pertains to life and godliness that can help you to succeed. So where have we gone wrong with this in the family, in the body of Christ? Where are we now in lacking to feeding to, you know, feeding to the body, you know, regenerating the Word of God so that it can get into this younger generation, or it can get into the mindset so that it can grow? All it takes is planting the seed. So where are the
seeds? It's the seed that's missing. It's the seed that's missing. We're digging the hole. We're tilling the ground. But we're not planting the seed. That seed is the faith. Faith is that thing you cannot see. So we're tilling the ground and we're doing all the works. We're buying the flour, the fertilizer and all that. But we're lacking the faith. So because we're lacking the faith, we're causing our next generation to see instead of experience.
That's the difference. That's the difference. We won't missing out on the experience.
The experience.
minutes. We don't want to tarry
anymore.
That's
what we talked about.
We want to hurry up and wait.
Yeah.
You know, we don't want to tarry. We don't want to lay prostrate before the Lord.
Before the Lord.
Lord, I'm going to bless you when I get in my car as I'm driving. You don't have my focus because I'm paying attention to the streets.
And thank him on the way.
Yeah.
Those quick thank yous.
The Burger King praise.
But when you really need him.
There you go.
We know what we need to do.
Right.
But we do it when we really need it.
That's the only time.
We're going to lay before him.
That's the only time we want to be uncomfortable for God is when we need him.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So when trouble rings your doorbell and like you say, if it's the loved one that you know you want to, you know, we all need to increase our faith. But what happens when that diagnosis shows up on your report?
Yeah. So we don't want to wait till we really need him.
Right.
We want to be that way all along. We don't want to wait until I really need you, God. Mm-hmm. I want to thank you every day. I want to lay before you every day. I want to give you that intimacy time every day. Not wait until there's a need, emergency need.
Right. I want to be so intimate with you. Mm-hmm. To if cancer come upon my body, I'm going to say, God, you gave me this to carry and I'm trusting you.
Because
you're right here with
me. I'm standing on your word. Yeah.
I'm standing on your word.
Because the word is in me. Because
that's
all along I'm praying and I'm believing and I'm trusting.
Right.
So now this thing is before me. So now, God, I just got to just walk in what you gave me.
Right.
I'm trusting your word. I'm walking in it.
Yes.
I'm believing and I'm trusting you.
Yes.
Yes, what we're talking about. So that our faith fail us not. That your faith might not rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God.
Yes.
Our discussion question, we're going to get into it for for the next segment, but we're going to be dialoguing about where have we gone wrong with the generation, with the cultural behavior of today. We are talking about faith and the family in our next segment of Matters of the Heart. I worship you. Hebrews 1 says, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things that we don't see with our natural sight. And so we have to learn how to activate that now faith. We have to know that now faith within us causes our belief to grow and to be magnified, and for us to worship and be able to say out those type of declaration and praises unto God when we say that he is a way maker, that he is the promise, you know, keeper, that he lights, he gives us the glow, but God who lights our way.
Yes.
It's that now faith that we must activate in our lives today. Yeah. Lady Sylvia, what do you have to say about that?
When I think about that forward faith, I think about direction, the direction ahead of us, and what's going to happen now. So when we think about the forward faith, it's thinking, okay, God, what about the now? So we stay so deep in the now, we're not looking at where we're going, where God is trying to take us. He wants us to move forward. God tells us that, you know, he's prepared us. He's equipped us. He says, so now, ready, set, go. Go into what I've already instored in you. He said, walk into what I already restored in you. Don't stay in the now. God don't want us to stay right in the now. So when I think about forward faith, and I think about the word of what God has already given to us, he said assurance. I have assured you, my daughter. I assured you, my son.
Right.
Walk in what I have given unto you.
Right.
That's
right.
What he wants us to do. So he said, trust me. Move with purpose. I have a plan. I have a plan for you that has came forth. I have equipped you to do what I have asked you to do.
Right.
There's people waiting on you. So what he has given in us is not just for us. It's
That's
for
right.
others and for us to go forward
right.
in what he have for us.
Right, and that reminds me of what, you know, what we did in ministry. Was that about 2 weeks ago?
Yes.
Last weekend when we had the pouring of the
oil,
the anointing service at our prayer breakfast, because that's how we pour out.
That's how we do.
That's how we, you know, give into this generation that we're speaking of, that we're saying, where have we dropped, you know, where have we dropped the mantle? You know, where are we going with the, you know, with the millennials? How are we to bridge this gap? You know, we got the cultural wars going on. We have so much that's going on. And one of the things I know that you had shared with us personal, you know, in our car ministry, you know, on the way down, you know, we were talking about, you know, some of the things that we are not putting our foot forward to do when we're talking about faith. But we have to speak.
We have to speak.
We have to speak to the generation in order for them to know. So some of the things that, you know, like you said, some of the things we need to
I was sharing with the ladies in our awesome car ministry that when I think about how we need to continue to pour into our younger generation, we have a family. And it's not just the younger generation when you think about it, Lady Cook. Some may not have children in their home.
That's true.
So we have to minister to what? Each other.
Right.
Because ministry starts in your home.
That's right.
Husband and wife.
That's right.
Children.
Right.
So, but for me and my house, we got away from, and we're starting back to do that, but we got away from years ago that we used to do it every Thursday. Every Thursday we would pour into our children. Every Thursday we would have that time for that 1 hour where we sit, you know, just to see how one another is doing, pour into our children as they grew so that they can understand the word for their self. Just because they get a certain age, that don't mean we just, okay, you on your own.
That's right.
You know, we still got to continue to minister to
them.
So there should be a time, like in my home, we had every Thursday, 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
We called it back then, come to Jesus meeting. And they'd be like, oh, Lord, here come to the Jesus meet, Mom. But we made it fun. It wasn't just like I'm sitting there and I'm like, okay, bam, here's the word, and I'm badgering them. But we made it enjoyable for them. So they enjoyed when we came together because they have questions too. Believe it or not, y'all, it's not just the children that has the questions.
That's true.
There are us. There is the grown. We have questions, believe it or not. That's real talk.
That is real.
We can sit in church over and over, every week after week after week, and someone is standing before us on that pulpit, and they're sharing a word. And some of us is too afraid to stand there or raise our hand or go up to my sister, my brother, and say, I don't understand that scripture. Mm-hmm. Do you mind sharing? Mm-hmm. Or what do you mean by that when you say that?
Right.
So that is how I look at it, you know, in my household.
Right.
So we're getting back to that place to where now we're sitting together because we're seeing the effect of it.
And Lady Silver, you know, that's in the home, but we need to get to that within our churches as well.
Amen.
Within our communities.
Amen.
We need to have more dialogue with the young people. We need to know what it is that they don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be able to hear their reasoning for it. Sometimes there's a lesson there to be learned from the
for
the instructor.
The mm-hmm.
So they teach us. You know, they're the millennials. They don't think like we think.
Mm-hmm.
They don't.
Exactly.
They don't experience the things that we've experienced.
Yes.
You know, but for so long now the churches are even having the microwave faith.
Exactly.
You know, you run through there like a car wash.
Mm-hmm.
You run through the church like a car wash.
Mm-hmm.
You run through there like a car wash. You know, nobody's slowing down to say, explain to me what it is that I just said to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And so much go unknown until there's a loss of interest.
Yes.
There's no motivation there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to go there to for what? I'm just going to sit there and text on my phone the entire service.
Mm-hmm.
You, a lot of times from the pulpit, we provoke people to disrespect God.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
We provoke people to disrespect God because we're not engaging them.
Mm-hmm.
They have no idea that they sat there for 45 minutes, as you said earlier, and they have not a clue as to what you said. So now we're provoking them to disrespect God because these little devices, okay? We've disrespected them a little bit too because now everything is electronically. Don't know that Revelations is not the first chapter. Because on our phone, all we got to do is put the REV.
And it comes up.
And it comes up. So everything is so microwavable now.
Mm-hmm.
But God is calling us to a true relationship with him. He wants the intimacy. He wants us to know who he really is.
That's
he wants us to know that he is the way maker.
Mm-hmm.
And that's so important. It takes us right back to, you use the word again, engage. But not only are we not engaging with this, you know, with this culture, with this generation, but the impact. We've got to have a good impact with this generation. Mm-hmm. We got to feed them the words of faith. It's just like you say, it's like planting that seed. Because even with faith, we've got to know that inactive faith causes an outwardly denial of God.
That's right.
That's just what you said. So the Bible tells us, even in Matthew, it tells us, but whoever denies me before men, I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got to get back into the root of impact.
That's right.
We've got to get out there and go. That's what I love about this ministry God has given to me, and the vision of being able to cast the nets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
To be able to go out, like you said, go out into the community, go out and engage with, you know, with families, sit down and talk with someone and
don't be so rigid
and think that, oh, well, you know, they don't look like me and they don't dress and they don't carry the Michael Kors bag that I have on or the red bottom shoes that I may have. Look, I'll go down to Finley Park. I'll go to the park with my red bottoms on.
That's right.
Hello, somebody. And I have pearls and everything. You know, I have the ladies, you know, they'll pick at me sometimes. You know, I'll put on a jogging suit and a pair of pearls in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still about my Father's business.
That's right.
About doing and spreading and you know, working the vineyard. Working. Who would go? Who will go and work the vineyard with me? You know what I'm saying? It's not about what we look like. It's not about what we wear.
Mm-hmm.
It's about carrying the word. And then also it's when we share it and see what we get so afraid of sometimes. And I'm going to have to go there. You know, you did say real talk.
That's
I'm going to have to go there for a moment to say that sometimes we get so afraid to address these people because we know that they've seen us outside of a Wednesday night service
Say
or a Sunday morning service.
Say
they've seen what we look like on Friday. They've seen that, you know, we might have been somewhere we wasn't supposed to go on a Tuesday, and we wasn't carrying the Bible bag, or we wasn't carrying, you know, we didn't have on our collar, and you know, and all this other things. And so this generation, you know, they watch.
That's right.
They watch, and they see what do, and they're seeing that you're up in the pulpit on Sunday or on a Wednesday, and you're giving them, like you say, you're giving them the scripture, but are you living that life?
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Are you living
that perception?
Yeah.
It's that perception. It's what they see is what they're going to know of you. Exactly what they see is what they're going to know. So here we are. We won't deal with certain topics because those topics convict Sister so-and-so, or those topics convict Brother so-and-so. So I'm going to dance around that and not teach or preach on that because the let's be real, the offering might go down. Yeah, the offering might go down. So I'm not going to talk about that. I'm not going
because they may leave.
Because they may leave, and they are great tithers, and they're this and they're that. But prepare yourself for that great day for God to say, Pastor so and so, Sister so and so, Brother so and so, depart from me.
It's time.
Because I know you not. Because that's not what he would have us to do. He would have us to speak about the goodness of Jesus. He would have us to know that, guess what? Unless you've been uncomfortable, you really don't know who he is. If you've never been uncomfortable, if you've never been faced with something, wondering how.
How am I going to get through this?
How am I going to get through this? And that still quiet voice said, as you say earlier, stand. Still and know, oh my gosh,
this is good.
But we're not teaching people that. We're teaching them to go to the cash advance. We're teaching them to run over there to brother so and so and do it like this and do it like that, instead of teaching them go before God and see if that is his plan.
And that's what we were saying earlier. We've got to seek God with our need through our worship. And if it doesn't start there, if we don't know, you know what I'm saying? Everything starts, right? You know, everything starts in line right there. It starts with knowing that you can count on God. You know that you have that relationship with God. That's how we start to see through the eyes of faith. That's how we start to increase our faith and elevate our faith. So it all starts. We all have to start at the same starting point, I'm saying. And that's through a relationship with God. So we've got to learn how to equip ourselves to be the disciples like they were the disciples back in the days.
And ladies, look, we've got to tell people that it's okay to run. If you sit down McDonald's and you eat a burger from McDonald's and that burger makes you sick, you're not going back to McDonald's because you had a bad experience We got to take that same mentality when it comes to receiving the word of God. We've got to, if it's not growing me, then it's hindering me.
And that's a great way to look at it. That's a great way to look
at that. Get rid of your hindrance. And what so that you can go forth in him.
That's good. It's what you always say, Lady Cook. Be intentional.
Be intentional.
I wrote that while you were talking. We have to be intentional and aim for maturity in our journey. We have to. He wants us to move beyond spiritual stagnant.
God is good. That's good right there. We're going to go ahead and get us another another rejoice
Thank you,
there. Give us a rejoice, Brother Nate.
Look at somebody and say, I feel a breakthrough coming your way. Tell them it's a mighty move of God and it's going to change your day. Come on, clap your hands right there. It goes like this. I feel a breakthrough coming your way. It's a mighty move of God. It's going to change your day. Signs and wonders, miracles to perform. God is going to bless you, but just holding on.
I feel a breakthrough coming your way.
It's a mighty move of God.
It's a mighty move of God. It's going to change your day.
The signs and wonders.
mighty move of God.
Gonna
change your day.
Gonna change your day.
With signs and wonders.
Signs and wonders.
Miracles.
Miracles to perform.
God's gonna bless you.
God's gonna bless
you. But just holding on.
Just holding on.
Say.
Just hold on.
Now it's gonna happen. You wait and see. Yeah. All things are possible to them that believe. Come on, you say.
You've been expecting,
yeah,
changing your life.
Looking for your midnight.
Looking for your midnight.
Turn to sunshine.
Turn to sunshine.
Now it's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
Evening. As always, you can catch the show replay of Destiny Talk with Lady Cook on our podcast, which we have the podcast through Spreaker.com. So you can download that and you can catch the replay of all of our Destiny Talk shows. Connect with us on the second Tuesday of each month in 2019. We are looking forward to connecting with you, Destiny Walkers. Meet us for an evening of inspiration, laughter, empowerment, and networking. You can log on to the Lady Cook Ministries.org website so that you can find out about all of our upcoming events. You can sow a love seed, submit your prayer request. You can click on for membership. There is no fee to join the network. We also have support teams in the state of Georgia and Florida. So make sure that you are connecting with us as we are growing and glowing for the kingdom of God. Meet and greet with Lady Cook will be held Tuesday, February the 12th at 6:30 p.m. prior to our empowerment forum on that night. So we're asking you to come out, all of our Destiny Walkers, the new Destiny Walkers, the current Destiny Walkers. We want you to come out and fellowship with us and have a good time. And we'll give you more information on the ministry and how you can connect and how you can get involved. All right, to all of my hometown listeners, all those in the surrounding areas of Kingsland, Jacksonville, Fernandina, you know where you are down there. Apostle Monica McGowan and On Eagle's Wings Ministry presents You Have a Voice Women's Conference, Friday, February the 8th and Saturday, February the 9th in Kingsland, Georgia. You will be able to get additional information from my social media pages. I should have the flyer uploaded to my website this week as well. The space is limited, so don't delay. Get your tickets right away. Friday, February the 15th, Beauty for Ashes production presents Love on the High Sea Dinner Theater. Come celebrate Valentine's weekend with a night of love, laughter, and intrigue. The tickets are priced at $50 and the show will start at 7 p.m. Save the date for February the 15th at the Gala by JW, Columbia, South Carolina. As always, don't forget, you can follow us on our social media pages. Help me reach 1,000 followers and more on the Lady Cook Ministries Facebook page. You can find us on Twitter, Instagram. We have a YouTube channel. We are out there glowing for the glory of God. So come on, catch the glow and shine into your destiny. Well, as we are preparing for the closing segment of the show, I just want to say that I'm just excited about what God is doing and how the word of God is going forth. Again, we're always thankful to the platform of Power and Praise Radio so that this word is going forth all around the world, reaching those. We're planting seeds of hope. We're planting seeds of inspiration. We are putting out the word of God.
Yes.
And that's important. That's the root. That's the bottom. You know, yes. If you get down to the bottom of everything, of what we do, our purpose, and, you know, why we do what we do, it's through this ministry. It's spreading the word of God, and it's through discipleship and relationships that we know that the word works, and it will last, and it can work in your life. It can work in your life if you allow it to. So, Destiny listeners, we encourage you to keep tuning in to our show. We're on the air every first and third Tuesday of the month. And as my schedule permits, then maybe we'll get back on the show weekly again. But we're working that part. We're working that part out. To God be the glory, because it says if you have faith in things that you ask for, you activate your faith in those areas. And I know that God's will and his way, you know, we're lining up with the word of God. And so it's God's way, then it's his will. And so to God be the glory.
Amen.
For what he's doing for this ministry. So in our closing thoughts, I just want to encourage you all to allow, you know, to allow faith to be your currency.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Work what you know works and will bring back dividends.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying to you?
Yes.
That will bring, you know, that will make you prosperous. If we use faith as the currency in the kingdom of God, then we know that, you know, that you know, things will work out for our good.
Mm.
You know, it will work out for our good. Do you have any closing notes for the Destiny listeners, Lady Carolyn?
I do. I would ask our listeners to adhere to what Hebrews 10 and 24 says. It says, let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works. So with that, let's encourage everyone that we come in contact with, regardless of their standing, to keep going, keep praying, keep trusting, keep rejoicing, keep worshiping, and more than anything, keep the faith.
Keep the faith. Keep the faith. Come on, Lady Sylvia, give some closing remarks to our listeners.
And my closing remarks, I just ask you to hold on to Hebrews 11 and 1. Because just ask God to continue to empower you. Say, Lord, continue to empower me to live this life.
Yes.
You know, continue to take control of all my circumstances. Hold on and move forward.
Yes.
God said, ready, set, go. You are equipped. You know the plans I have for you. He already knew them way before we did.
Yes.
And don't be distracted. Hold on to his word. And I ask you to continue to build one another up in your families. Go back to what we used to know. Lay before him. Don't rush to thank yous.
That's awesome. That's awesome right there. And so in our closing remarks, we again want to encourage you to go before the throne of God. Go before God. God accepts you just as you are.
Yes.
He accepts you just as you are. And we know that it just not something that may come overnight.
Mm-mm.
Because even those of us who are well seasoned in the word of God, sometimes we, you know, because we're human, you know what I'm saying? Flesh will rise up and things will happen and it will cause us to sometimes falter. You know, sometimes some of the very topics that we teach on and that we preach on, sometimes they'll cut us too.
Amen.
Come on now. The word of God is a tool. Two-edged sword.
That's right.
And so you know what I'm saying? And so we've got to learn how to feast and feed on faith. Activate the faith and ask God to, you know, ask God to help you.
Mm-hmm. And in addition to that, Lady Cook, it's important that we connect ourselves. Mm-hmm. Find a seed that's growing.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Find you a seed that's growing.
Mm-hmm.
Stop eating food that you have to bring back up.
Mm-hmm.
Eat that which will get inside of you and manifest itself. Mm-hmm. So connect yourself with something that's growing. Find you a seed that's growing.
That's good. I like that. Get yourselves connected. Mm-hmm. And so with that, connect with us. I'm telling you, we're out
there.
We're out there. And I know that we're growing because of the seeds, you know. And
we're willingly doing what thus say the Lord.
Come on here.
Excited about doing
it. Out of obedience. Thank you, Lord. Out of obedience. Out of obedience. Out of the call of God and with the mandate that God has given us. So we are out there. You can go to our website and you can, you know, pull up the information about our ministry. And we're asking for you to, you know, connect with the ministry, connect with us. God is doing some great things and he's going to do more.
Amen.
Can I say that again?
Eyes have not seen. Hold Norman Hutchinson just said it.
A move of God is on the way.
A move of God.
Yes.
Already on the way to us. And so I'm just excited about it. I know that, again, sometimes, you know, like they say, we fall down, but we've got to know that through faith and with faith, it's okay. Engage with the generation. Engage with them through the word of God, through the works of God.
Let them know your failures.
That's okay.
Let them know how you overcome.
That's how we do it. That's how we show that we win together. We win together as family and be an impact. You know, let your life style, let what you live and what you preach about. And, you know, again, no one's perfect.
That's right.
But in Christ, come on here, somebody.
Right, yeah.
In Christ, if we put it all in Christ, we know that the perfection, what we're perfecting, what we're striving for, what we're, you know, what we're, where we're trying to go.
Right.
It's all for the good.
Yes.
It's all for the good.
And we all are able to go. Regardless to what, there's nothing that you've done in it that can stop God. He is willing and able. He said there's nothing impossible.
Nothing impossible. Y'all grab these scriptures of faith. Grab them. Write them down.
Operate in them.
You know, again, that's good. Operate in them. Let them impact your life. Engage. Engage in your life.
So and share them.
And share them. That's important.
Don't be selfish with this podcast.
Don't be
selfish. Mm-hmm. Share. Because someone needs to know that it is okay to say, I don't have it, but I want it.
How can I
connect with Lady Cook and those awesome women that are not afraid to have real talk.
Amen. And on that note, well, I guess that will close the show out on tonight. We pray that you have been blessed. We thank God for another week, another day, another opportunity to sing praises unto his name. And until the next time, y'all, we'll be back on the air. We say be blessed. We send you much love, much grace, and much power.
God bless you.
Stopping the shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. I'm so glad I thought I could die. But ain't no power stronger than the one who came and laid down his life. And I got more to supply. The enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Different, you know that's a lie. You gon' look back and the greatest victory of my life. Cause when it comes at your fast and hard, there's only one that can come and make it right. So ain't no need for stressing and crying, cause he gon' show up just like he did the last time. And the last time, and the last time. I know. Why you do it? Can't get you.
Fight your battles for you, ain't gon' wonder how you sleep.
All time.